niggas always talking like they really with it. I've been getting to the money, I've been stacking chicken.
What do you want me to do? You want me to keep listening, bro? Is it gonna change? Is the flow change? Let me see, does the flow change up? Come on, man. Come on, man. What are we talking about right now? What's going on, man? What's happening with your life? Let me tell you something, bro.
Bro, that kid, L nigga, whatever the fuck, you don't have no money. You broke as hell. You don't know how to count, you stupid ass nigga.
Who gave you the motherfucking keys to Detroit hip hop, bro?
I'm just trying to put my people on. You know.
Bro, this nigga Kid L is the dirtiest, lamest, bitch-ass nigga I ever seen, bro. I hate this nigga, bro.
You just be, seem like you playing with the culture or something, man.
I hate that nigga, bro. I hate him.
Yo, it's your boy Kid L, man. It's episode 49. Bro, 49 of the Fuck You Talking About podcast. Y'all already know I appreciate y'all for continuing to tune in. And everybody that's continuing to submit their music to keep the show running in the first place, man. As I always say, if you're watching this, please leave feedback for at least one artist in the comments. If you liked the song, if you hated the song, let the artist know why in the comments. First track of the night is Never Touch Zero, and the track's called What Happened? What happened, man? Okay.
Yeah, fuck niggas probably duck.
Okay, so you really got shot.
Don't y'all kill all right. Me, bro. Y'all ain't killed me, bro.
Damn.
A nigga probably see me flying in that fast thing. I heard one nigga saying it was cash game. Where them niggas came must have been a fucking hit. I seen them turn into a pervert cause I upped the dick. If you know me, then you know that I clutch a stick. Not for nothing, motherfucker, I'm a buster bitch. So two niggas rolled up on me and I bust a bitch. Then I bust his mans, then he bust my hand. I'm busting back, what he do? Nigga fucking ran. Hopped in a Chelly, did the dash, I was on the gram. Went to my mama crib, hopped the curb, crashed the whip into my partner crib. Went to the back through the strap, somewhere by the grill. Went to the sink, rinsed my hand. Mama thinking, nigga, damn, thought I was about to chill. Bullet went in and out, so I'm straight for real. Fuck it, went to the hospital still. I'm at the hospital with the hospital bill. Ask me how I'm about to pay through it, not at a grill. I'm mad as fuck, told Doc, patch me up, all black. You only see this on my face like Daffy Duck. Hell yeah, I cried, nigga. I could've died, nigga. I got shot, drove myself to the hospital. He got shot, fell.
I'm in a tough situation because you're talking about real shit here, obviously. I mean, you got shot and everything like that. Some real shit you're talking about. There's just one too many hospitals in that verse. Like, you said that shit like eight. It's just, come on. I mean, listen, man. I understand, like, you know, the reps there, like, it's all legit. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's real. But, I mean, the music still has to convey, bro. The music still has to be there. You know what I'm saying, bro? It's like, you know. It just, the music still has to be good, no matter how real the story is, no matter how real the background or whatever happened is, the shit still has to sound good. And for me, when I was listening to it, it just sounded too easy. There was no entertainment value for me. I wasn't sitting here going like, damn, that's some real shit, that's some real ass shit, damn, that's crazy. It was more just like, man, you said hospital like eight times. I know that's, you know, not, that's kind of lame for me to say, but it's the truth. It's just like, there's no entertainment value at the end of the day. If this came on the radio and people were driving to it, they wouldn't keep it on. You know, the story only conveys through the music video and the intro you have, but most people would not continue listening to that, to be honest with you. So, you know, just work on being more, you know, you have to work on your style, your flow, your delivery, making yourself more entertaining to listen to. Now, entertaining doesn't mean, everybody start dancing, entertainment means, like, it still has this, listen to Future. Future talks about real shit, too, but the way he does it, the way he switches up the flow, the tonality, the execution, the delivery, it keeps the listener engaged. Next track is Boss Game Blade. And the track's called Come Around.
Now you trying to come around. Now you trying to come around. Now you trying to come around. Now you trying to come around. Boss game.
Where the fuck was you when a nigga ain't half shit? Where the fuck was you when a nigga ain't half shit? Now you trying to come around cause I doubled off my last clip. Now you trying to come around cause I doubled off my last clip. Now you trying to fuck with me cause I bubbled off that last trip. Niggas trying to fuck with me cause they know I make that mad flip. Bitch, I'm about to boss up and get double off that last zip. Nigga, you ain't fuck with me when I ain't half shit. Break that bitch down, I need double off that last zip. I gotta double up cause I made double off that last trip. I do the whole dance, little nigga on half step. I damn near move the whole back, I only got a half left. Nigga, what the fuck was you when I was on my knuckle? What the fuck was you when niggas try to steal my custom? What the fuck was you when niggas try to steal my hustle? What the fuck was you when I had to be my muscle? What the fuck was you when niggas try to run off? Same niggas that's out here looking lost. Now you tryna fuck with me, nigga, cause I'm a boss. But I ain't never seen you there when I took a loss. I can move the whole bag, nigga, without a loss. I can buy the whole bag, nigga, what's the cost? Tell the plug, flood me, nigga, cause I'm a boss. I can move the shit real fast, I get it off. Where the fuck was you when a nigga ain't half shit? Where the fuck was you when a nigga ain't half shit? Now you tryna come around cause I doubled off my last clip. Now you tryna come around cause I doubled off my last clip. Now you tryna fuck with me cause I bubbled off that last trip. Niggas tryna fuck with me cause they know I make that mad flip. Bitch, I'm about to boss up and get double off that last zip. Nigga, you ain't fuck with me when I ain't half shit. Nigga, you ain't fuck with me when I ain't half nothing.
I'm sorry, man. I just can't keep listening. It's just not, there's no entertainment value for me here. There's nothing that's making me want to keep listening. And guys, I'm very well diverse in music. I listen to all types of music. I listen to hip hop, rock, jazz, fucking bluegrass. Fuck is you talking about? I listen to all types of shit. I know good music, bro. I'm sorry, bitch. I know good music, and this is just not a good song. It's just not. It has its good parts to it, and it shows that you have some type of potential. And if you just keep grinding and working it out, and just keep in the studio, eventually you'll find something that works. But to me, this is just really boring. I'm sorry, it's just really boring. Even the music video is boring. I know he did that 3 clone shit, but that was, he didn't even do nothing with that. He didn't even scale and post. It's just a boring song. You hear too much of this stuff. It doesn't separate you from anybody else, to be honest with you. I hear this every day from different artists. Everybody's just trying to just do the same shit, and it doesn't make you stand out, and it keeps you locked in the bucket. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're just going to be with everybody else, and you got to find a way to get out that bitch and be free from all that shit. So you got potential, man, because you at least you tried. I'll give it to you that way. Like, you tried with your lyrics. You weren't just saying bullshit. Like, everything was coherent, but the entertainment value is not there. That usually comes with time. Next is Sleazy Link. The track's called Freestyle City Flow.
I don't wanna go and get it, I've been running to the sack, right? Niggas talking about that shit that was in your past life. Goofy little bitch, don't give a fuck about what you talk about. I been getting to that money in my trap house, moving pounds, 250. Niggas always talking rounds, but they ain't blickies, I'ma go and get it. These niggas talking like they want it out of camo round. Niggas always talking like they get it.
What the fuck are you doing, man?
And that's a couple, that's a 30 round. Niggas always talking about that shit, but give them one of the rounds. I been on my bag, I on my block. Niggas always talking about some shit, they be shot. I'ma get this money, niggas talking like they pop. Chop a smacking nigga if they grind to Tony Hawk. I'ma go and get this money.
That was a good line.
Niggas talk about the money, they be steady wildin'. Dig a little bitch, niggas always talking shit. I been getting to the money like what's this? Niggas talking like a bitch. They will fuck with niggas on, they don't shit. I been getting money.
What are you doing, bro?
Niggas talking like a shit, right? Getting to the money, tell a good night, damn.
What are you doing?
Bitch. Niggas always talking like they want their own shit. I been getting to the bands, bad bitch on my dick. Niggas always talking like they really with it. I been getting to the money, I been stacking chicken.
What do you want me to do? You want me to keep listening, bro? Is it gonna change? Is the flow change? Let me see. Does the flow change up?
Niggas always wanna talk about it. I don't give a fuck. I got them racks. Yeah.
Come on, man. Come on, man. What are we talking about right now? What's going on, man? What's happening with your life? Let me tell you something, bro. I don't know what you're doing in the studio. I don't know what you're doing in the booth, but it's not what I've ever heard any other artist do, where like you probably are just staring at a piece of paper and just running through it, and you're not even like, I don't know what the fuck you're doing, man. What do you want me to diagnose the shit? I ain't a fucking mechanic, bro. Like, come on, man. This is just every level. The flow is just, it doesn't engage me. It doesn't make me want to listen to the lyrics. What are you talking about, bro? What are you saying to me? Fuck is you talking about, man? I think that's why I called the show Fuck Is You Talking About. Because, like, fuck is you talking about? You're not saying anything. You're just talking. That, what the fuck? Like, what? What does anybody want to hear somebody just mumbling and mumbling through the lyrics that have no substance, no meaning, no entertainment value to them? What part of that was sweet? Do you listen to your own shit and go, like, yo, this is heat? I bet you don't. So where do you start? Listen, man, you got to just go listen to music. You got to just go listen to music and diversify. You need to start understanding proper structures. And once you understand structures, you can break rules. I hate when people break rules before they even understand structure. Like, Blueface probably understands how to make a song sound normal, but what he did is he mastered it so well that now he can break the shit into pieces and do whatever the fuck he wants with it because he mastered the game. Like Michael Jordan. I mean, I'm not trying to compare Blueface and Michael Jordan. I'll never compare them. But I'm saying Michael Jordan mastered the fundamentals of the game before he started doing all the extra crazy shit. Allen Iverson. You master the fundamentals, and then you can start doing your own types of shit. But that was just off on all dimensions. You know what I'm saying? So start exploring, man. Kind of figure out your position in this game. Next up is K9 Kells and tracks called Not Important. That's what my ex says about me all the time. What are you talking about? I'm gonna start giving y'all grades now. I'm gonna start giving y'all grades. Because I didn't give any of the last three guys grades. I'm gonna start grading y'all. I'm gonna give you A, B, C, D, E, F. Is this song started? Okay, we're gonna skip the intro here. What's going on, bro? Okay, thank you for that. I don't even know what the fuck that was.
Bitch, I'm not important. They don't wanna see me working. Bitch, I'm not important.
Oh my god.
They don't wanna see me working.
Not important, they don't love me, they don't wanna see me working. In and out the mall, I'm really one hump splurging. Smacked, it's out of gum and coffee, what's the wax? I'm hot, I'm a product, I don't wanna sell that. She put the claws on me, gotta scratch my back. The cat all black, crush me, you don't want that. You ain't paid too much, your diamonds looking kinda flat. The pussy on me, so I had to smack that. Disrespect, I regret, don't wanna show the past. Drop by, shut up, pause, I left it in the past.
Yeah.
That nigga went fast, yeah. Catch your lip and ass. Bro, what the, got the act real fast. I was young back then, we ain't never get a pass. You on probate. Shit, yo ass, I always smoke a blast. Bullet fly to your face, you got a gas smoke that. I ain't gonna lie, I had a better life than you fuck niggas. What nigga, you can't even make a buck nigga. Fuck bitches, was always on to the next nigga. Hard times, break
I like it.
Mind. Glad I can't bind you alive. Dick and parallel, we are not aligned. We divine, it's a sign, I can see it with my eyes. Bought a piece worth 10, you know I'm just getting mine. I know I said I got money, but I had to stack mine. You spend short, that's why you don't have a fucking dime. I was getting impatient, can't waste no more time. Bitch, you crazy, it's just really thick. I need you in my life. Get stressed about shit. Thank God that I'm alive. When I leave, they think that I'm not gonna survive. I'ma rise your teeth till I die. No lie. It's bloody, bleeding. I was looking kinda fuzzy. Hurry, he going out of you. Might get real lucky. You been raiding over me. Never seen to get sun. Real buddy. I portray the tree like a monkey. I'm out here living life. They think a nigga lucky.
Hey, this is cool. K9 Kells is actually kinda cool, man. I like this. It all starts off with your tonality. Starts off with the flow. Starts off with your. Again, your tone of voice here is, for whatever reason to me, I fuck with it. I just like listening to it. I like it. And I like the execution of the flow. I like how a little bit of switch up. I like how you kind of just matching the beat perfectly here. You're keeping your voice moving. You're keeping it interesting throughout the song, which is important. A lot of artists don't understand that. You got to make it, your voice is just as important as the beat. You got to do, the beat's switching up, the beat's doing crazy shit. That's what sometimes your voice has to do that too. It depends on the song, but you executed the song very well. Obviously you have potential. Obviously you just keep grinding, keep working, and you'll be separated from everybody else just because, you know, you're doing a little bit different and you're doing it well. Next track is Moschini Jones, and the track's called Rude.
First things first, nigga, shout out Rookie, nigga. This Rude hoodie look way Rude. Better on me than it do a lot of you other niggas. Step your funds up. First off, let's get straight to it. The right wrist, bust down Cuban link. The left wrist, all gold, yellow, presidential, bitch. I don't get two fucks by the broke ass nigga or broke ass hoe. It's all on the broke bitch, from now on. For the 9-9 and the 2 triller. Nigga, I don't give a fuck. I'm out here doing my thing and I'ma do it in the well. I got some fuck. motherfucking Zara jeans on as we speak. I took them in Birmingham and got them motherfuckers tailored. Now they feel real good all on the broke bitch. Shoes off, white nigga. Hustle home, gang nigga. If you ain't hustling, you're damn broke bitch.
My bitch calling me woo like my hoodie. Ay, two-tone, what's goodie? AR-4 slingshot, bitch, pop out, chop suey. Hong Kong fooey, stick same size as Stewie. Ay, my bitch is bougie, all your bitches choosy. My life's a movie, rock off white like Coogee. Fall like Bob Cousy, fuck you niggas, sue me.
Hey.
Get that toolie, smoke them fucking moolie. Get them coolie, no more humble shit. Riding on that jungle shit.
Yeah.
They are jam, blow the clip like some cartridges. Business ain't no Sega Dreamcast, I don't play games. Cookie pack, you hit it with that girl, you turn to Rick James.
Hey, hey. Yeah.
We got straight drop, we got fatty. We got balls in the air, finna catch him.
Finna catch him.
Fuck on me and my mans, how you messy?
You a freak.
Birdo stepping on the work, finna stretch
it. What up, Birdo?
I see through you weird ass niggas, y'all some plastic.
The plan.
Niggas always asking for the price, but never grab it.
Weird ass nigga.
Hey. Niggas always asking for the price, but never grab it.
Never grab
nigga,
it.
Get your lame ass off the trespass. So much smoke in this bitch, a nigga damn near passed out. If you don't come back with
hey, Moschino Jones, I was actually fucking cool. I fucking liked it. I just liked it. I don't know. You at first I thought this was about to be just some random like generic ass shit, but then you fucking hit me right away. You hit me pretty quick. Like, yo, this dude is doing it. He's doing it the right fucking way. I'm listening to this bitch. I'm entertained by this bitch. I love the music video. I love y'all's performance. I love everything about this song, to be honest with you, man. This is an example of a song that it separates you from everybody else just because you're executing so well and you're keeping the energy there and you're not letting people sit back and relax. Like, you're letting people, you want people to engage with the song and be a part of it and be in it. You complimented the beat very well. This is just a good all around track. Thank you for sending that in. Next track is Key the Heater, and the track's called Energy. Key the Heater. This has 51,000 views. God damn, what? Can't say shit to you now, can I?
I like my bass down low, ain't got no love for a hoe. And if they trippin', they could meet me outside. I'm sliding with the 30 in a pole, vacuum seal on a bows. Yeah, we really bout this money, let's ride. Yeah, I'm on north side, south side. Fuck them all, east side, west side. I like my bass down low, ain't got no love for a hoe. Twisted fingers still reppin' my squad.
At the club, but I ain't tippin'. Rub, blue, they know I'm crippin'. Keep a pose, oh, I ain't slippin'. Here I'm talkin', so I'm grippin'. Stayin' true to my religion, drippin' juice. And she ain't Christian Jimmy Choo. I don't even think she knew the difference. Tell him it's squad only shit. Get your homie here, niggas is fried. Get you in them, that's a bonus clip. We on a job, had to sell myself, pure ownership. Now I'm just hoping God put me on the list. I'm my zone again, cutting your mold again. I came up out of the gutter, just like a bowling pin. Thought he was playing with chicken, but that's some corner shit. She let me squirt her the mouth, then we bring the quarter cents.
I like my bass down low, ain't got no love for a hoe. And if they tripping, they can meet me outside. I'm sliding with the 30 in a pole, vacuum seal on a bows. Yeah, we really bout this money, let's ride. Yeah, I'm on north side, south side.
Yeah.
All east side, west side. Bass down low, ain't got no love for a hoe. Twisted figure still repping my squad.
I had to boss up. This ain't last year. It was a toss up. You gon' crash here. Shit, this cashmere. Niggas mad queer. Been gone five straight. Niggas mad still. It's a headbanger. I need some Advil before we break kill. Make sure the bag feel. He in a bad deal. They on all that. I got receipts too. Nigga, this all fat. Shotgun with the shotty. All the talk of these shotty. Little nigga shit leaders. All they catching his bodies. I'm sliding with the family. All shooters in the money. Lex Luger with the body. Old school Kim
Asami.
Hey, Key the Heater. This was a fucking solid track. I liked it. I liked the energy. I liked the excitement. I liked this music video too. Your performance is great. And obviously, you got everything well orchestrated with your director, the storytelling. Very fun video. Very fun song. Very real song too. I was listening to those lyrics. That shit felt real. I really fucked with it. I fuck with your guys' movement. I feel like you guys take this shit seriously. And I already know I'm going to be seeing you guys somewhere big soon. Just because you're doing everything fundamentally correct and you're keeping it entertaining. So you guys are doing everything the right fucking way. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate y'all for sending that one in. Next track is Apollo Kid, The Story. Apollo Kid, The Story, okay.
Let's go. Story of my life. When I was just a newborn, I had no teeth, so it was nothing I could chew on. But I remember moms had to get us couple coupons, cause she ain't had the money just to take us to the food store. But me, I was a young nigga, always in the Atlas. Despite me and my brothers, just was sleeping on a mattress. Was never good at school, but I was always good at rapping. That's when I figured out I had a talent. So when the beat drop, I would spit, and niggas will feel my passion. Cause everything I do would just go platinum. And all I got is mixtape shit and a couple singles. So imagine if I was to do an album, I would fuck the game so hard that I would bust. So guess what, I'm thinking I'ma need another magnum. Definitely I'm the answer, the truth, the cure, the savior for hip hop, cause I know it got cancer. So I'ma get this money and get up out the hood and heal my mama's broken heart. Like my name Miranda Lambert, I'm about to throw a tantrum on all these rap niggas, cause to me they fucking ugly. And I'm so fucking handsome, I'm on another planet, floating what? Just like Aladdin. My flow is fucking nasty, you would think I'm spitting maggots. We in a different bracket, smoke niggas like magic. When I get on a track, I be making these niggas panic. Cause when I open the boot and get in, I spit and turn around and see all these niggas writing again. Put the ice inside the gym, put the mic inside my skin. You know that I'm riding heavy like I just came from the gym. Baby, soon, real soon, you see my name up on a blimp. Or maybe be a pimp and be fucking bitches like Kim. I'm a giant like Goliath, you niggas should grow an inch. I hope you cover your nose because my shit stinks. I be ballin' like Jordan back in 1996. Or maybe Derrick Rose back in 2010. Shout out to all the people out there who listen it to Apollo and fuck the niggas that be dissing him. I'm a master regardless, painting pictures like artists. You wanna talk about flows, well let's see who can flow the longest. And I'm just being honest, I'm better than you, I promise. I'm about to call Bin Laden and ask him who the bomb is. My life is like a vomit, you wanna puke it up, cause you know that you ain't fortunate.
Not bad at all, my friend. I feel like you remind me of the 90s in a good way. Modernized 90s. This is a compliment. Just really, 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 really solid. The beat you pick alone obviously entails everything. That kind of shows where you're going for. And I do feel like the 90s atmosphere, that 90s aura. If I heard this in the 90s, it would be solid. Everybody would be like, yeah, this dude is heat. No, I mean, what I'm saying, reminiscent of a little bit of, not to say Big L or anything like that, but just like the flow and tonality, and that, you know, your punchlines, you're trying to hit each one and make sure that each one's solid. I like it a lot, man. I'm a huge 90s, early 2000s, like, hip-hop fanatic, like, when it comes to, man, like, Wyclef and, like, you know what I'm saying, like, Nas, and, I mean, I'm a fan of Nas, I'm not a fan of Nas, but it just depends on the mode I'm in, and this, if I was in that mode, like, that Nas-type mode, this is one of those tracks that I would kind of listen to at that time, you know what I'm saying, but, yeah, man, I like deeper woke rap, but there, if you guys ever heard of a rapper named Chaos, Kevin Brenton, he's from Toronto. In the early 2000s, he had a superstar, he had a lot of fucking great, Joyful Rebellion, he had a lot of great albums he was dropping, and he was kind of doing what you're doing here, but he was doing a little better, you know what I'm saying? K/OS, go look him up, man, because when you start talking about other rappers and they're fucking up the game and you're here to fix it, he's the guy to listen to, because just the way he did it, it's like he was so fucking good at rapping that you couldn't deny him, and he was trashing other rappers at the same time, because of, at the time when Chaos was coming out, he knew lyricism was dying, he knew substance was dying, so he was like spitting lyrics that are like, yo, everybody get the fuck up, because you guys are fucking up the game, I'm here to revive the game. So Chaos was really a person you should go check out, man. He's trying to do the same thing you are with this track. But thank you for sending that in. You definitely have a lot of potential. Just keep grinding, keep working, figure out how to make yourself sound more entertaining and more engaging, and you'll be fine, my boy. Okay, this next track is by Ross Dion, and the track's called Brutality. Put my hood up for this one, boy. Sounds like it's about to be wild.
Hey, I'm swatching my movements like they at the movies. Your girl fucking with me, her boyfriend is fruity. She shake her ass on me like a smoothie. My plugs, they were deep, I am grounded and rooted. Call him Big Moochie, they call me Big Moochie. We reach out and then we don't quit till we stupid. Say you a killer, bitch, come out and prove it. Your block is a cock looking dusty and useless. Pray to my necklace, 6K on my hazers. My blessings protected, bitch, fuck who you pray to. Suit up and take off, I'm running these play calls. My heel
shit cannot be unsaid. John Wick with the stick. Stop when they dead.
Listening to this, you're just yelling in my ear, man. I see the lyrics here, and I see you spend a lot of time making sure that, you know, your lyrics are intricate and very well-developed, but it doesn't matter, man. Lyrics, it's just like new Eminem, man. The new Eminem is just, you know, he thinks just saying lyrics and rhyming is going to make everybody go like, oh, he's the god, he's the greatest. This is not what rap's about, man. Yelling in people's ears just because you have intricate lyrics here that rhyme doesn't mean anything to me. I'm not feeling anything when I listen to this song. And if this is supposed to be a pump-up song, I'm not pumped up. I'm not feeling any type of way. I just feel like somebody's yelling in my ear. Okay? I mean, listen, the smartest man in the world, you know what I'm saying? Albert Einstein or whatever the fuck could be yelling at you all types of crazy ass formulas and shit, but I'm not going to listen to him if he's yelling at me. It just doesn't sound good. There's a way you do things. Put it that way. There's a way to do things. This wasn't the way. This didn't feel good. I'm never going to listen to the song again. It just doesn't have any type of feeling for me. No type of feeling. Feels like you're trying really hard too. And I don't know how to put it, man. It's so hard because there is talent involved here. It's not like you're not talented. It's just there's no interest in for me to listen to something that's attacking at this level and has no connection with me. It doesn't connect with me at all. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't connect with me at all in any type of direction. Sorry. I mean, that's just the way I feel about it. It does not connect with me. Next, what you need to do is learn about, like, understand people more. I feel like you're trying too hard, man. It's kind of, that's it for this episode, y'all. Appreciate y'all for continuing to tune in. If you made it this far, man, leave feedback for the artist, man. This is about them. It's about them getting feedback from more than just me. I'm only one person, you know what I'm saying? So anybody who wants to drop and give feedback, it's much appreciated. Love y'all so much for tuning in, man. Episode 50 next week. Tag anybody that should be on the next episode. If you want to be on it, hit me up. Peace.